Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time it is when you're watching this. We are Kristen and Sia of Hopscotch the Globe.
In this video, we're going to be sharing with you something that has been requested quite a bit, because we've shown our wardrobe in a few videos, and you guys have loved that, but all we get in the comments are, show us your jewelry, we want to see your jewelry collection, because we have pieces that we've collected throughout our travels over the course of like 15 years. So that's what we're going to be sharing in today's video.
This video is sponsored by Ring.com, which is a security camera system, alarm system, and we use them in our home, so when we're traveling, we can check in on our home and make sure all of our stuff is safe.
You can check out a video we did all about how we keep our home safe when we travel. There'll be like a little pop-up right now. So you can check that out after this video. Okay, let's talk about jewelry! I have had this piece in my collection for 15 years. I got this during my first trip ever to Paraguay when I was living there for 4 months in Paraguay, South America. I was teaching English to children and learning Spanish and living with a host family, and it's the trip that made me fall in love with travel. And I found this piece and I really liked it because it's super organic. I liked the person who was selling it, super friendly guy, and I still have it today, which is great. I didn't lose it. This is made out of coconut shell that has been engraved, and there is like this, I don't even know what kind of shape this is, but I like it, it's funky. So that's coconut shell, and then there's these like little leaves that are made of coconut shell, and then these little beads too that are all made out of coconut shell, everything except the actual thread. It's like a hemp, which is really nice material. It's super light to wear and very organic looking, which is the type of jewelry that I am attracted to the most.
This right here is cocaine. It's actually a cocaine leaf, a coca leaf from Peru. So when Kristen and I were in Peru, we were hiking the Andes, we came across this like artisan jewelry maker, and he told me that this is the leaf that they make cocaine out of. This is not enough to do anything, he said. You'd need like, you know, bags and bags and pounds of it. But I'm still a little nervous bringing it over. I love it because it's a leaf, like you can see it through the glass, and then it's wrapped in silver. So it's like, it's a beautiful natural piece. Pretty neat.
We're gonna have to get a real close up of this with the other camera. I get so many compliments on this ring, especially from like older people. They really like it. They're like, oh, that's such an interesting ring. That's really pretty, the shape of that. But they don't actually know what it is. And until I'm like, look closer. I'm gonna leave it up to you guys to figure out what this is. Look closely and leave a comment below letting me know what it is.
These two pieces, this necklace and bracelet, actually go together as a set. I got them from a tribe in the Amazon. We were spending the night with this tribe, and we saw them making this beautiful jewelry. These are like seeds that you can find in the Amazon. And then these are some other type of seeds, these red and black seeds. And then at the bottom, this is my favorite part. It's kind of broke since then, but at the bottom is a piranha jaw. So it's actually the jaw of a piranha. You can still see the teeth there. So it was my first time in the Amazon, which was incredible. And this piece reminds me of all of that. I should really get this jaw fixed, because I'd like to bring this back. And then the bracelet, all very natural. And this black and red seed that's in the middle here, you can actually find it all across the Amazon floor. It grows on a plant, so pretty neat. If you find one of these, you know, you can turn it into jewelry.
I wear these earrings quite often. I got them in Belize, I think about 5-6 years ago. It was my first time to Belize, and I was on an island called Key Cocker, which I fell in love with. It's a very, very chilled, laid back atmosphere with really awesome rastas everywhere. Very, very like laid back people. And I was going slow, taking my time, walking barefoot around the island, and I came across this vendor, this artist making jewelry right on the street. right in front of you, and I saw these really beautiful earrings, and I loved the teal color. I loved how big they were. So again, a statement piece. And I bought them. I love supporting local artists, especially when they're like making their art right in front of you. I love these and I wear them often. And every time I wear them, I get so many compliments.
Before we get to more of our jewelry, we want to take a moment to talk about our sponsor, Ring.com. So Ring has set us up with an entire security system within our place so we can keep stuff like our jewelry safe when we're traveling and we're not here.
They have doorbell cams, they have floodlight cams, they have ones that are battery powered so you can move around your house.
Yeah, and it's all tied to our cell phones. So like when we're away, we can actually get notification that someone is at our door, someone's rang our doorbell, someone's left a package there. We can talk to them if we want. And we can just check in on our place, which is just good peace of mind, especially for like big travelers, right? Just to have peace of mind really helps. And it's great that, you know, Ring has helped us create a ring of security around our house.
And they want to give you a special offer. So if you head on over to ring.com/HTG, you can go and check that offer out. Now back to our regular scheduled programming.
This is a medallion from a secret community of people in northern Italy that have a temple in a mountain. That's not a joke. That's actually where I got this. It was a very loving community. It was very accepting of all religions. And this medallion that I got from there was made there by an artisan jeweler. And it encompasses a lot of tribal and primal and religious symbols. I love this and I wear it often, and people are always asking me questions about it, and it starts a really long conversation.
This necklace is one of the most, or the most important item of jewelry that I have, because this is what Sia proposed to me with. It wasn't a ring, it was a necklace, and this is a moonstone necklace. And at the time, we had just separated for about a few weeks, and I went to the south of India, and Sia went on his own solo adventure in Nepal to hike the Everest base camp. And he found this necklace when he was there, and he didn't buy it with a plan to propose to me with it, but it just ended up happening that way. When we got back together in India, in Rishikesh, in our $4 hostel room, he had kept this necklace in a sock stuffed into a mouth guard case to protect it. And we were just in like this conversation, and the moment was right, and he went and he got his mouth guard case with this in the sock, and he opened the mouth guard case, and I was like, okay. And showed me this necklace and proposed to me with it. Yeah, it just has so much meaning, and I wear it almost every day. And I love the way that the sun reflects on it. It lights up like a star. And it has like this like blue purpley color that reflects as well, which I love. It's beautiful, simple, beautiful, and very me. It's like very fairy-like.
This here, I designed and got made from somebody in Toronto. He was like a jewelry maker on the streets of Toronto. No, he wasn't homeless, but he had like a little stand on the street. And I wore this at our wedding. So instead of wearing a tie or bow tie, I wanted to wear a crystal. So I picked out the crystal. I picked out this red leather. I mean, the hemp like purple strap, this like leather necklace, and everything he made from scratch. Even like how it like snaps together with like a little hook. Like he made that out of metal on the spot. So This has a lot of meaning because I wore it throughout our wedding, and crystals are supposed to absorb the energy around them. So this, you know, has the energy of our wedding within it.
This necklace is also one of my favorites, simple. It's a Ganesh, who's one of Hindu gods, remover of obstacles. I bought this when I was in India by myself, traveling for 3 months solo, and I didn't really dive into the spirituality or know much about like yoga and the whole spiritual world before going to India. And I got this little Ganesh pendant as a representation of this new journey at the time, and I just felt really safe and good when I wore it, and I still do. Now that's a statement piece. I got this a couple years ago when I was in Hungary, and it's a very different type of piece. It is humongous. It is a statement. You can't just wear it with anything. I would wear this with like solid black, and then this piece is like what stands out, right? It really dresses up an outfit and makes people look and makes people ask about it. This was made by a local artist in Budapest. I gravitated toward this piece because it's completely different than anything else I have. It's made out of leather and some other shiny material on the front here, and it's all recycled material, which I like, because I don't really like to have leather goods unless it's recycled leather. I like these little spikes too. It makes it a little bit more edgy. Very unique piece.
I really love rings. This is a ring that I got in Mexico recently, and it is the Aztec calendar. I've always been drawn to the Aztec calendar. I've always loved that symbol, that circular symbol. I found this on a ring, which I love because I can put it on and I can wear it. I can have it anywhere in the world. I mean, I'm going to Pakistan soon, and I'll bring this and I'll wear it. Maybe some locals there will ask me about it, and they've never heard of the Aztec calendar. They haven't been to Mexico. So I think it's a fascinating piece to bring around the world, as well as bring back from the world.
We hope you enjoyed this video. You have been requesting it for a while, so I hope it fulfilled that want and need.
Yeah, it was cool to actually go down memory lane a bit too, and see these pieces of jewelry. Some I haven't held and wore in years. So it was neat for me too.
Totally. To do this video. Yeah, it just made me realize again how much these items mean to me, and that it is my favorite thing to collect when I travel. And when we downsized everything, we did not downsize our jewelry because it has so much meaning and it doesn't take up a lot of room. So if you're looking for things to collect throughout your travels, consider unique pieces of jewelry.
And if you haven't already, please go to ring.com/HTG to see your special offer, because we love using these cameras. We have them all around our place, and we want you guys to feel safe and protected when you're traveling too.
If you have a unique piece of jewelry that you got when you were traveling that you want to share with us below, share your story, share your, describe your piece of, your item of jewelry as well in the comment section, and I can't wait to read what you guys write.
Yeah, that would be neat. You can even send us Instagram stories too. Yeah, send us Instagram stories.
Yeah, you can get links to our Instagram accounts if you're not already following us in the description box below. So we hope to get some DMs from you guys. Okay, bye.
Bye.
Say bye, guy.
Bye-bye. She doesn't know bye yet.
No, not yet.
You only know booby? You want booby?
She wants booby. Let's go have some booby. Booby time. Booby time.
I want some booby time.